أسوي
You then.
Why don't you come back quietly, Dan? Save yourself some pain. Fair enough. Who have you told? Nice of you boys to finally join us.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hello, Danny.
You missed me.
Looks like you lost a tooth there, Danny.
Enough. Take him back with us.
Fine.
Get him out of here.
How much do you think he knows?
We'll find out soon enough. As you were, Stockwell.
Boss.
Hello, Daniel. You gave my boys quite a run around this afternoon. And I hear you haven't said a word, despite all this unpleasantness. Oh, I get it. You're a hard man. Well, you've made your point. But enough is enough. So why don't you just tell me what...
Daniel Mason. Sergeant. 251.
Yeah. I know the routine. I've been where you are now. Fallujah. 4 years ago. Those ragheads introduced me to concepts of pain I could never have imagined. Would have killed me too. Except these boys swung in against orders and got me the fuck out of there. You know, I served in the Gulf with your old man. He was a tough old bastard.
You're not fit to say his name. You're a disgrace. All of you.
What happened to your dad today? Was regrettable. Good effort, old man. And your mom? Wrong place. Wrong time. Dan, for whatever you believe in, just for the sake of an easy death, tell me who you're working with. So are you prepared to die for your sense of honor, Sergeant Mason?
Since the day I joined. So why don't you get on with it, you piece of shit?
My love is in there somewhere.
Hi, John. Dougie here. It's been a while, so to God you still get your messages, mate.
Hello, Cardinal. Oh, do just let me, please. I am on the phone.
Listen, John, I know it's been a while, and look, regardless of how it was between us last time you were here, Dan and I have been working on something, and it's all gone very deep end. I hoped you might come back here and give us a hand for old time's sake.
Oh, maybe that's Daniel now.
John, we need your help here now. Come.
Ah, yes, hello. I used to serve alongside Sergeant Daniel Mason. I believe he is stationed at your barracks. I'm actually in town for a few days. I was hoping to catch up with...
I'm sorry to have to tell you that Sergeant Mason was the victim of a terrible beating. And subsequently, he was stabbed in the back of the neck.
Any leads on who did this?
Nothing that I can confirm. You were local, sir?
Used to be.
The report says his commanding officers assumed he'd gone AWOL, but then the body was found on the outskirts of town by a section returning to the barracks.
Who filed the report?
A Sergeant Hatcher. One of his men contacted the emergency services immediately, but unfortunately, Sergeant Mason was pronounced dead at the scene.
What about his parents? What are the police doing about this?
I believe our local constable is investigating both incidents. I'm not sure how much he's found out. And if I'm honest, he's not exactly the brightest spark. But here are his details. Again, my condolences on your loss. As I understand it, Sergeant Mason and his family were well liked. Is there anything else I can... Sir?
I'll take down the bastards that did this. Every one of them. But you knew that already.
Would you look at that? A real-life ghost.
It's not really him. Can't be. Permission to move in? He's listed as a priority target. Should we...
Negative. Hold positions.
Your orders, sir?
What are you even doing here?
Sir, your orders.
Well, if I were you, I'd order in body bags. Lots of them.
Hatcher has more than 20 years' experience, all the usual theatres.
Highly decorated. But it is my belief that his men went rogue on a job in Afghanistan.
So, me and Dan are going to start digging around. July 2nd. According to Dan, Hatcher and his men are in a spot of bother. The RMPs are still trying to find out exactly what they were up to on their last mission, specifically the 2 days that they spent deep inside Taliban country that Hatcher still can't account for.
Dan at the moment is trying to get something concrete on what they were up to.
I've told him to be very careful.
Hatcher is one ruthless bastard.
Well, you haven't been around lately.
Yeah, sorry, it's just be really manic around here.
Well, you know where we are.
Yeah, sure. Better get back to work.
Bruce.
It's running as usual.
I don't think so.
I'm 18 in 4 months.
Yeah, and in 4 months, I'll buy you a drink to celebrate.
Here you go. On the house, of course.
You see me reaching for my wallet?
What are you after, pal?
I'm here to find whoever murdered Sergeant Daniel Mason.
Sorry, come again.
I said I'm here to find whoever murdered Sergeant Daniel Mason.
Well, Dan was well liked around these parts. Whatever happened to him was a tragic loss. You taking the piss or something?
Something.
If all things work out, you won't have to work again.
What are you saying to that?
Looking a bit harassed there, Lambert. You run out of nuts again?
Sandra, she's finally told him about the chlamydia. He's been scratching on me.
New face. Just walked in and announced he's here to find Dan Mason's killer.
I'll take care of it.
Easy. Just point him out to us, Lambert.
Nothing? None of you have got anything to say about Dan Mason. His parents, Dougie and Etty, lived around here for 30 years, pillars of your community, yet not one of you has a single thing to say about their brutal murders. You got something you want to tell me?
Mister, I'll watch you mess around with Randy if I were you.
Would you now?
Listen, it doesn't look like anyone here can help you. So why don't you just go?
Excuse me? I knew the Masons. A little bit. Sis.
Yes?
They came into my cafe from time to time. They were nice people. It was very sad what happened to him. I don't know if it'll help you much, but if you want to come in and talk, we're there every day.
Look, come on. We don't want any trouble here. Best you just move on, eh?
Thanks for the advice. But I'm not leaving town until I find out what happened to the Mason family. And if anybody has a problem with that, I'll be outside. Was fast.
You think you might be a bit lost?
No. You best stop shooting your mouth off, pal.
And leave town for your own good.
I'm going to ask you one time, politely, who killed Dan Mason?
And I'm going to tell you once. Get the fuck out of here, or you're a dead man. You got it?
Everyone? Everyone, listen. There's totally gonna be a fight. Come on.
Fucking fight? Brilliant. What are you talking about?
Look. We're trying to be reasonable here, we... We're done here. I repeat myself.
Trouble?
some random prick.
You're in over your head, so consider this a fair warning. Leave Devotion and don't come back. Do I make myself clear?
Let's go.
Come on, people, show's over.
You okay? Mister?
Tip top.
Look, I couldn't say anything back in there, but I knew Dan Mason. Yeah, and if you just come with me, I can tell you everything. Seriously, I can help.
Fine.
Come on, sis. I love that vodka now, then. Sure, really. Danny Mason was a good man. Quite a gentleman. I'm Sandra, by the way. What's your name? Suit yourself. Do you like music? What kind of music do you like? Here we go.
How did you know Dan?
Oh, just from the pub, really. It was nice, though. Tip well.
What do you know about all of this?
Just what Keith's told me, to be honest. Sounds awful.
Keith?
Yeah, he's my friend. We help each other out and that. He's lovely.
What does Keith know about Dan?
Oh, I didn't really ask him much after he told me what happened, to be honest. I was a bit freaked out, actually.
Take me to him.
Oh, well, Keith mostly keeps himself to himself these days. I doubt he knows anything at all.
Bollocks.
It's open, come through.
Hiya, Keith.
Oh, Sandra, babe, thank God, you've got my rollies. Who's this? Sandra?
No, don't worry, it's all right. He's all right. So this is Keith. And Keith, this is
You all right, mate? How you doing?
Better than some.
Oh, what, these? Yeah, I'm lucky I've got Sandra to look after me. She's my own personal angel, isn't she, babe? Come and get Keith some sugar.
Keith!
Sit yourself down, mate. So who are you, anyway? Army, police, crew, what? Sandra.
None of the above.
All saints be praised. Have you got a, here, give us a light, babe.
Oh.
So what can I do you for?
2 days ago, my friend, Sergeant Daniel Mason, was killed. I'm here to find whoever did it. Sandra seems to think you might be able to help me.
Whoa, slow your roll, mate. What makes you think I know anything about anything?
Oh, well, I kind of told him that you did.
So what do you know?
Look, mate, I can see you're upset, but honest, I can't help you. Sandra gets a bit fucking divvy sometimes. I'm sorry about you, pal, mate.
What do you know?
Get the fuck off me!
Oh, please!
Sit down.
Okay, let me just...
Start talking.
Well, everything was cool until about a month ago. I had all the business in town and it was all good. When all of a sudden some new faces rock up, and I'm telling you, man, these geezers were heavy, man. They were fucking heavy duty. They made me take their product. Can I get up now?
Sure.
Hey!
Continue.
Well, things were all right at first, but then all of a sudden, I'm told until I pay them off, every penny goes to them. So 1 minute it's all good, the next I'm working for free, and who wants that? And when I say something about it, They fucking did this to me and kicked me out my gaff. So now I'm not working and I've got nothing. If I didn't have Sandra, God only knows, mate.
It's not all bad, though, is it? Some silver linings.
Who are they? Where are they?
Come on, brother, they'll kill me.
I'll kill you.
Please, stop it!
Tell me.
Hatcher. His name's Hatcher.
Hatcher? As in Sergeant George Hatcher.
What, you know him? No, bollocks. I don't want nothing to do with this if you fucking know him.
Hang on. What would a highly trained special forces team want with a broken town like Devotion?
Well, look around you. No one gives a shit about us. They can do what they want here. No one's going to stop them.
Yeah, my love.
Thanks, babe. I mean, who's going to mess with the special fucking forces? Oh. What, you? Well, fucking good luck with that one, mate. We'll have you fitted up for a coffin in the morning if you want. Save you the bother.
Where do I find Hatcher?
Take your pick. My old place, the Army Barracks, the Devotion Women's fucking Institute. He's everywhere.
You don't leave town. We're leaving.
Sandra. Sandra, babe. Sandra. Sandra. Fuck.
You know, you didn't have to hurt him.
He'll live. Where's Hatcher peddling his drugs from?
Well, it's at Keith's old place, but it's a proper shithole. And you know what? I really don't think you want to go there right now.
Show it to me.
Have you got a death wish or something?
Just take me there.
Fine. It's your funeral. This is it. Told you.
Not you, mate. Jog on. Are you deaf or something? I said,
jog the fuck on.
Yeah, sorry. I think they're just being a bit paranoid or something. Wait, no. They know me here, so maybe I should just buy something so we don't seem suspicious.
Right.
All right, come up.
Me again. How are you?
I knew you'd be back.
How many?
Just the one, please.
Two.
Yes, me. Our new friend from the pub has just shown up here. No, I'm not fucking shitting you. What do you want me to do about it?
Thanks so much. See you soon.
Not so fast.
Oh, hi guys. You all right?
Your friend? Who is he?
I don't know. I've never met him before.
Oh, don't fuck me about it, Sandra.
I swear, I've never seen him before he came in the pub tonight.
I want to know where he's staying. You'll find that out for me, won't you?
I mean...
Look at me.
No, I don't care what you have to do, Sandra, but you'll find out where he's staying.
And then you'll tell me, won't you? Won't you?
Done.
Sothel, what about the police?
What about them?
Sandra, talk to me.
You said it yourself, okay? Devotion is a broken place. You try going to the next police station, which is 3 towns over, by the way. See if they'll take your statement for getting threatened outside the pub. Our local copper was in there, for fuck's sake. Did you see him? Did he even lift a finger to help you? Stop you causing a scene outside? People around here, they're scared. Georgie Freeman said he was going to the police after that lot set his car on fire, and we never saw him again. Do you get it?
Let's go.
I'm sorry I got angry earlier, all right? Are you sure this is the right way? There's nothing but fields out here. You don't talk much, do you? Oh, it's, lovely. You're en suite in there.
When did you last see Dan?
Oh, well, it was, a couple of days before here, you know. It's horrible what happened, isn't it? It's gonna be bloody freezing in there. I could, come in for a bit, if you like.
Go home, Sandra.
my darling.
Dan has been in contact with the
county police, and it would appear that the drug business and Devotion has gone through the roof since Hatcher set up shop.
Background on Hatcher's team. Barnes.
Is he second in command? She worked harder than all of her male counterparts to achieve rank, and it would appear that her long-term ambition was to join under Hatcher. Marshall has made a career out of being a psychopath. Countless reports of him assaulting unarmed civilians in foreign climes and other heinous acts, all somehow overturned by Hatcher. Stockwell. Stockwell's hair-trigger temper has seen him pulled up on charges of insubordination in every unit that he has ever served in until Hatcher took him under his wing and gave him focus. And Lambert, he's beaten everyone there is to beat in the area of unarmed combat. Congratulations, Lambert. Hatcher's men are utterly loyal to him. July the 17th. Dan suspects that Hatcher has been doing business with a notorious drugs cartel run by one Sonia Last. She's as ruthless as they come. Been on watch lists for years, but thus far untouchable. Etty, don't water them, darling.
It's the Blue Barn on Hobden Rise. I
didn't see anyone else. Listen.
You're not gonna hurt him, are you? Only, last time.
Grab the target and we're gone. Nice and easy. On me.
I'll call it in.
Bollocks. Look what he's done. Let's just make sure he's dead.
Balls on the man. We give him a verbal warning and he kills four of ours. Hardly a proportionate response.
I knew it. We should have finished him at the pub.
What do we have on him?
I ran that through the system, and there's a match for his face from about 5 years ago. But his files indicate that he's been classified as a priority target.
Anything else?
I'm working on it.
Morning. What can I get you? Go clean up out back. Violet.
Morning. She's at that difficult age, eh? How's business, Rose?
It's fine, thanks.
How much for this one?
It's not for sale.
Says 30 quid.
Look, what do you actually want?
That loudmouth at the pub last night. Apparently you told him he can come here if he wants to chat.
Everyone's welcome here. To eat, drink, chat, whatever. He just seemed upset.
And how exactly are you going to brighten up his day?
I hadn't actually thought about...
Breakfast would be a start.
Oh, hiya.
Morning.
Morning. Everything okay?
She's fine.
Rose, is it? Am I too late to get breakfast?
That's right, and we serve breakfast all day. Just take a seat and I'll be right with you. Coffee, tea?
Coffee, please.
Black, no sugar?
Good guess.
Expert me, my specialist subject. Here you go.
Thanks.
Well, you know my name. What's yours?
Oh, John.
Just John? Well, just John. What can I get you?
You know, it all looks good. Surprise me.
Right, you are. Do you like it?
Who's the artist?
She's an excellent cook.
So, how well did you know the Mason family?
About as well as I know any of our regulars. Etty was very picky about her food. Dougie would clean the plate. And Dan, he was somewhere in between. Liked everything burnt, though.
Sounds like Dan.
You know, don't take this the wrong way. You don't seem to fit into this town.
Meaning?
You're nice.
Thanks.
It wasn't a compliment. Devotion, this whole place. It's really nosedived since I last came here.
And how long ago was that?
Well, the point is, all the nice people have moved away, so...
What am I still doing here? There's not much to tell. Dad used to run the place with Mum. And, I helped him after she passed. Until he joined her last year. This is all I've got left of him, really. Someone's got to look after trouble over there. She drives me mental sometimes, but she's all the family I've got left.
You ever think about moving somewhere?
Nice? Yeah, sure. Everything's tied up in this place. And Devotion's not exactly overrun with people wanting to buy properties, so...
What can you tell me about my friends from the pub last night?
Thinking of causing more trouble, then. Look, all I know is they walk around here like they own the place. My friends and I do what we can to stay out their way. This is too much for... Oh, thanks. I know you probably want justice for the Mason family, but you might want to think about leaving town.
Thanks. It's not justice I'm after. You're right, by the way. The artist is an excellent cook. Keep out of trouble, you.
That was utterly sickening.
Hello, Sandra.
Jesus! Wait! No!
What's she doing back here? Come up. Word with you.
Move.
Or
I'm gonna decorate this place in a delicate shade of your skull and brain. You too.
All right, just don't shoot, yeah? There's a lot of flammable shit in here. You little shit.
I'm sorry, he made me.
Concentrate.
Easy. No one has to die. Just take what you want and leave. You. Look, it weren't personal at the pub. It was just business. Shit, we're trying to do you a favor. You got no idea who you're messing with.
Say, concentrate. Sandra, don't.
But I just...
Yeah.
are cut off.
Get off me! I'm going to fucking kill you!
Oh, fuck you guys!
No, fuck you!
Jesus Christ. Look at the mess you made here.
Oh, sorry.
You. Oi, Sandra, I'm talking to you. You want another hit? Bring me that phone over there.
Sandra, don't.
Do it now. Well, come on!
No! Sandra!
I'll deal with you later. As for you, dickhead, you should have left town when I told you. Now you're gonna...
Now then, an elite special forces team turned gutter-level drug barons. Discuss.
Get fucked.
Come on, out with it.
We were sent to Afghanistan to take down a major drug lord. We intercepted it on a private airstrip, and when we were done, it was just sitting there.
It?
A massive block of heroin. Enough junk to set us all up for the rest of our lives.
And?
When we talked about it, Hatcher's never seen us wrong. And he saw it as our retirement plan.
So you smuggle it back and take over the local drug supply?
Boss thinks it would be the best way to start. Plus, what do we know about selling this shit? So we found the local supplier and squeezed.
Tell me about Dan Mason.
He found out what we were up to. Knew we were setting up a deal to send the shit on to Amsterdam.
Go on.
Well, why don't you ask her? What sick loser she hangs around with.
No, no, I didn't do... We didn't do anything.
What's he talking about?
They are gonna kill you.
It's me. Yeah, he's still here. He
You just killed some soldiers and set fire to the local drug factory. No, I don't know that yet. No, I don't know that either. Yes. Yes, of course. I just said yes. Why the hell would I drive all the way down here then not tell you when? Of course. I didn't mean to. Why is everybody pissing me off today?
He's an honest-to-God, real-life hero. Or at least he was. John Gold. Military Cross. Back in the day, he single-handedly neutralized more insurgents in 1 year than the rest of his section put together. He was a one-man war machine. He all but disappeared just over 3 years ago, and he's been completely off-grid ever since. There've been rumors of him appearing in serious hotspots here and there, but nothing verifiable.
Why'd you leave?
I'm still working on that. But it had something to do with an op in Eastern Europe going sideways. Total disaster by all accounts.
Focus on his return.
Well, it's not official. No authorizations for him on the system. The only real connection is he served with Dan Mason a few years ago, and Mason Sr. was their instructor.
It's personal.
Yeah.
That's good. No reprisals from above. We eliminate him, we move on.
Job done.
Please, don't kill me. Please, I'll do anything you want. I'll do anything you want.
Yeah. Hold on, I'm putting you on speaker.
I said the place has been burnt to shit. And Lambert and the others have been wiped out. Reckon it'll take 48 hours to get up and running again.
This prick just seriously cut into our productivity.
Name's John Gold, ex-regiment. Turn over our local contacts. Find him.
Stockwell.
If you do find him, do not engage.
Report back for orders first. Is that clear?
Roger that.
Marshall, think strategically. There's no point in all of you chasing Gold around town.
Get ahead of him. What does he want?
Us, apparently.
Exactly that. One way or another, he's coming after us, and then we'll deal with him.
Now, Sandra. Later, babe. Shit. Sandra.
Where is she?
Tell me about Dan.
I told you before I had nothing to do with your mate.
You know more than you've told me.
About what? I don't even know what you're on about.
You know, Sandra set me up this morning.
Mate, I don't even know, I swear.
You set up Dan too?
No, don't, please. I didn't do anything.
You think I haven't seen all this before? I know what you are, what you've done, what you deserve.
What, Sandra? I look after her and she looks after me, for fuck's sake, just ask her.
She didn't stand a chance with you around. But I'm gonna give you an opportunity to do one good thing. Tell me what happened to Dan.
I keep telling you, I don't know. For fuck's sake, if you want me to say something, just tell me and I'll fucking say it. But I swear to God, I had nothing to do with your mate.
Next one goes right here. Talk.
Okay, all right, just listen. Dan found out about some deal Hatcher was doing with this big-time Dutch cartel, Tulips and shit. He told Sandra he was going to report Hatcher to the fucking high command or whatever. He liked her, he trusted her. He told her to get out of town and lay low till it all blew over. But she didn't. She came and told me because she wanted me to go with her. Because I told you, she worries about me. So, yeah. I went to Hatcher. I thought if I helped him out, he might cut me back in on my old patch, you know? Please, please, I've got nothing, mate. They've taken everything from me, and I just wanted something for myself. Please, please.
Go on.
When they found out that Dan trusted Sandra, they had her tell him about the meeting Hatcher was having with the cartel. But obviously it was a setup. They knew he was coming. And she told me about it after they... You know. But honest to God, she didn't know what they was going to do. She just thought they was going to run him out of town or something. She wouldn't hurt a fly, that one. So what? What are you going to do? Please don't. Fucking... Please don't. I told you what you wanted to know. Please don't kill me, man. Please don't fucking do anything. Please. Oh, my good God. Oh, my God. Keithy's got to move.
Some questions for you.
Oh, whoa, what did he say?
So, where do you and the other traitorous wankers hang out then?
Fuck my...
Where?
Are you kidding? You feeling it yet? Killing house outside of town. I'll fix it. We train there.
You do Dan in there too?
I just took guard that night. The others, they...
Sure, you just guarded the door while they murdered my friend. That's totally fine, obviously.
No.
Good. Got a location secured. We'll be back in business by tomorrow night.
Splendid. Let Larson know that we're ready to do the deal. Sergeant Barnes, let's prepare a suitable welcoming party for our friend.
Boss.
Are you okay?
Jesus! Am I okay? Are you okay?
Look, don't go back in there for a while. Let the police handle them. Never mind.
Oi! Where have you been? Wait, what happened? Are you all right? Thank you.
Not now. Seriously.
Later, then.
What?
Come on, I'll show you. Thanks ever so much for helping.
Yeah.
What's this then?
We used to wear them on missions.
Who's we?
My old unit, Dan and the others.
Oh, well, where are they now?
They're gone.
Those things will kill you, you know. What do you reckon you lost? Probably need to have an orange juice or something. It was crazy back there, with that guy with the gun. What do you think actually happened?
I know what you did, Sandra. I know about Dan.
No, I didn't, Look, I'm really sorry I helped them, okay? I never thought that... But I can help you now, okay? I'll do whatever you want, I swear.
Sandra, I want you to know that I understand you're a victim in all this.
What do you mean?
You've been a victim your whole life. This place, Keith, Hatcher too. I just want you to know that I understand that.
I am so sorry that I told them where you were. And I'm so, so sorry that I told them about Dan. I never, ever... It's just... It's the stuff, you know? I need it, and... I can't... I'm gonna quit, okay? I'm gonna quit, and I'm gonna help you. If you just let me help you, I promise. I swear I'll quit.
Let him come.
Hello, sunshine.
Go.
So you're still coming, then?
Looks like.
You do realize you're on a suicide run.
Actually, in 10, Maybe 12 minutes. You'll all be dead.
You're in no position to... Gold?
Boys are ready.
Excellent. We'll let Gold come to us. End his interference, then he's back to business.
What's this prick look like then?
Oh, who gives a shit? Just shoot any prick you don't recognize so we can piss off down the pub.
First round's on me, lads. Maybe top dog, but I'm the main event. Yeah, you're really tough and scary.
Yeah,
and you're about as hard as a baby's first shite. Oh!
And I've been looking forward to this ever since outside the pub. Welcome to Glasgow. Do you know the real highlight for me over the past few days? Is putting those perfectly round bullet holes in poor old Eddie Mason. That, for me, chum, was a real treat. This one's for Eddie.
I think it's time for you to bring Gold to me, Sergeant Barnes.
Boss, are you sure you...
Bring him to me now. That's a direct order.
Look. Gold, is it? Hatcher wants to face you one-on-one. Me? I've seen what you can do, and I'm not crazy enough to take you on. Gold? I'll quit all of this right now. Just let me walk out of here. I just want to go. Deal or...
No deal.
Do come in. You've impressed me, Gold. I could use a man like you.
Not interested.
On with it, then. I don't get it. All this aggravation for what? The Masons?
Yes. Not just the Masons. Brotherhood, loyalty, queen and country.
Brotherhood? The money from this? It's going to the families of men we've lost. Families the government left to rot. We saw an opportunity to make it right, and we took it.
And you killed innocent people in the process. Good people. They didn't deserve any of this.
Need a plaster or something.
Thanks.
I'll see you soon.
You better not.
All units stand down, regroup at Point City.
Seriously though, who is that guy and where's he going? All right, anyway, are you sure you're all right?
Fighting fit.
Oh, great. Well, in that case, please, can I hold one of your guns? Oh, come on, just a small one.
We are gathered to commemorate the life and passing of Dan Mason. May he rest in peace. Let us remember all those who have died for their country in war and peace. Those whom we knew and those whose memory we treasure.
Good journey, Dan.
Gold?
Frost.
We were wondering what you were doing up here. You always did have a habit of going all Charles Bronson at times, didn't you?
You coming to take me in? Your team's as subtle as ever.
Far from it. All core science is a zero. Stand down. Walk with me, John. Look, off the record. What you've accomplished here in a couple of days is more than the department could have done in months.
What about the families of Hatch's men?
Intel gleaned from Hatch's computer show funds transferred to a dozen different accounts. But honestly, I came here for you. John, I know this has probably been difficult for you. But you're always our best field asset and we need you back on the job. I'll tell you what. Take some time, sort your head out. Go somewhere tropical. And then come back to us. And we can crack on with work. Well. Gold?
Hello? What's going on? Is it from him?
What does it say?
It says, shut up and do your homework, Violet.
You okay?
Every day is perfection. You?
Oh, it's been a little bit stressful.
You ready?
Can I drive?
Nope.
Where are we going?
I told you, London.
What part?
A nice part.
Nice. What kind of music have you got?
No music.
No music? That's so boring. Oh, what about my music? You can play my music on my phone. Hang on one sec. Oi!